Hello there, welcome back to IntelliCAT Tuition School series of revision video. My name is Jimmy, a math tutor in center, and today I'm going to share with you another chapter of the JC H2 math, which is summation. I would like to summarize this concept called sigma notation because I realized that over my years of teaching, many students face this difficulty of not being able to understand this sigma notation and the concepts behind it. So, let's get started. Okay, first of all, what is sigma notation? Sigma notation is used to sum things up, right? Sum means S-U-M, right? That means you need to add up some terms, alright? So what is sigma notation? Is denoted by this symbol, something like E, okay? And this is the general term. Alright, this is called a general term. General term. And this number here, usually you'll see a number here, R equals to 1. Alright, this one stands for the lowest value of R, right? That means it's starting from R equals to 1. And usually you'll see a number here, let's say it be n, and this number here stands for the highest or the maximum value of R. Alright, so basically I'm summing up a general term UR from the starting term, the lowest value, all the way to the maximum value. Okay, let's give an example. Let's say I'm summing up from 3 summation R equals to 1 R. Alright, so R is my general term. I start from R equals to 1 and I end with R equals to 3. So first step, what do you do? You put in 1 inside, because remember this is the first term, right? So you put in 1. So when you put in 1, what do you get? You get 1, right? Then plus. Okay, why plus? Because this one stands for summation, right? Right? This one stands for summation, so that's why it's plus. So 1 after that is what? 2, right? So you put in 2. Okay, 1 plus 2. Then after that, plus 3. The last one is 3 because you end with 3. Right? So this one is an example of a summation. Okay, what happens with n? If on top is n, then what do you do? R equals to 1 R. So you'll get 1 plus 2 plus 3. Okay, because n, you don't know what number is it, right? So you have to put plus dot dot dot, which is 4, 5, 6, but you can't write all the way. And you end with a n. Alright? So basically, I'm just summing up 1 plus 2 all the way until n, right? N is the last term. Okay, some important notes to take note. Okay, important points. Right here. Alright, first of all, this R is called a dummy variable. Alright, that means I can actually change the letter here. I can change it to I, that means in other words, this is exactly the same as this. It's also exactly the same as this. Alright, you see what I do? I just basically change the R to I. If I change to I, then he also must change to I, right? And then if I change to J, this must also change to J. So the R is a dummy variable. I can just replace with any other letter. Alright? This is some important notes. Okay, another important thing to think about is summation. You can actually break it up. You can break it up into like this. Okay, if you are summing two variables, you can actually break it up. It becomes n summation r equals to 1 r plus n summation r equals to 1 1, right? So you see what I did? I just break up the plus into two summations. Okay, the third property is you can actually take out a coefficient. Let it be a r, where A is a constant. Alright? So I can take out the A. Okay, take note, I can't take out the RL, right? Because the RL follows the variable here. So I can take out the A. So I'll get A n summation I equals to 1. Okay, understand? So these are some important notes to take note. Okay, with that, we'll come to the important formula. I'll let us summarize some important formula that we need to know for this chapter. Formulas. Okay, first one is to sum a constant term n summation I equals to 1a. Well, you think now that the value here is different from the value here, right? That means the A is actually a constant, it's not a dummy variable. Remember what I mentioned about dummy variable? Dummy variable means if the letter here follows this one, then this one is called a dummy variable, right? This one is a constant. So what I'm doing is I'm putting 1 inside, so I get A, right? Plus, if I put 2 inside, I still get A. I put 3 inside, I still get A. So basically what I'm doing is I'm summing up A. How many terms do I have? I'm summing up A in total of n times. Okay, how do I get n times? Very simple. You just take this minus this plus 1. Okay, write down here. This is another important note. The number of terms. In B summation R equals to A by R is equals to, you take the top minus the bottom, negative plus 1. This is the number of terms in the summation. Alright? So the number of terms in this summation is this minus this plus 1. So I'll get n times, right? So in the end, I will get n A. Okay, this is the first formula. This is called the sum of constant. Where A is constant. Alright? Okay, the second formula, which is n summation I equals to 1 R. Okay, so first of all, you put in 1, you get 1. You put in 2, you get 2. You put in 3, you will get 3. All the way until n, right? The formula is equals to n over 2 n plus 1. Right? This is called a sum of AP. AP in short form, it stands for arithmetic progression. Alright, which I will cover in the next video, which I'll be doing up soon. It stands for arithmetic progression. This is the arithmetic progression means the numbers are increasing by number every term. Alright, so this is the second formula. The third one, which is n summation I equals to 1 R square. Okay, you put in 1, what do you get? You get 1 square. You put in 2, you get 2 square. You put in 3, you get 3 square. All the way until n square, right? Okay, the formula is equals to n over 6 n plus 1 to n plus 1. Alright? Okay, the fourth one, which is actually a sum of R cubed. Alright, I will get 1 cubed plus 2 cubed plus 3 cubed plus all the way until n cubed, right? So basically, this is just a square of this. Alright, it's very easy to memorize. So it's basically just n over 2 n plus 1 square. That means the square of the formula here. Alright? Okay, I'll just erase the top one so y'all can see. There's a last one. Alright, which is the sum of a GP, geometric progression, which is n summation I equals to 1 e to the power r. Alright? So I put in 1, what do I get? I get e to the power of 1, right? I put in 2, I'll get e to the power of 2. I put in 3, I'll get e to the power of 3. and all the way until 8 o'clock end. Okay, this is called a geometric progression. In short form, we call it GP, which I will again cover in the one of the next video. Alright, this one is sum of GP, right? Geometric progression. And the formula is equals to A bracket 1 minus R, sorry, A, because your common ratio is A now, to power of N divided by 1 minus. Okay, so these are the 5 formulas that you need to know, because these formulas are not given in the exam, formula list. So make sure that you know how to apply all these formulas to solve the questions. Alright, and finally I would like to say some common mistakes which a lot of students make in this chapter. And so please don't commit this mistake. Okay, common mistakes. Okay, first of all, the first common mistake that I see the students make is student forgot to put the bracket. Okay, please remember to put the bracket. Why? Because this is not the same as this. What's the difference? Okay, for this, you are summing up the R plus 1, right? In total. That means you are summing up this whole thing in total. But for this, you are only summing up the R followed by you add a 1 at the back. Okay, so these two are totally different. Please remember to put the bracket. Okay? And the second common mistake is student neglected the starting term. Alright, this is not the same as this. Okay, let me explain why. For this, I'm summing up A how many times? I'm summing up A in total n times, right? So my answer is A n. But for this, I'm summing up in total n plus 1 times. So it's A bracket n plus 1. Alright? And the third one is, which I see a lot of students commit, is alright, this thing note is not equals to this. Okay, these two are not the same. For this, I'm summing up, for this one, I'm summing up 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square all the way until n square, right? Okay, but for this, I'm summing up 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus all the way until n bracket square. So, obviously you can see, right, this is not equal to this. Alright? So these are three of the most common mistakes that I see a lot of students make. So please take note of this mistake and don't commit them in your exams. Alright, of course, what I did is I just summarized some of the important concepts in this chapter. That's not all. For math, practice is essential. However, it's not about doing a lot of questions. It's actually about doing the right type of questions. So in our period center, I actually summarized all the questions into the different concepts and categories so that our students are able to master the different type of questions. And once again, my name is Jimmy. I'm teaching JC Math in this school. If you have any question, please feel free to visit our website or call our hotline 6280-6841. Our tuition center is just located opposite Serangoon JC and it's very near Kovan MRT. Once again, thank you for watching this video and I hope to see you soon in my lesson. Thank you.